News and Views. I'm John Banville. Our guest this week is Senator Marty Golden. Senator Golden, thank you very much for being here.
Thank you for having me, John.
I want to talk to you about the legislative session. Earlier this year, we discussed your priorities for the upcoming year. You wanted to create jobs. You wanted to contain spending. You wanted to work with Governor Cuomo to improve the quality of life for all the residents of New York State. Senator Golden, I'd like to know, how do you feel that we're nearing the end of session? How do you feel that this session has been for the people of New York? Are they getting something out of it? Has it been good for them? Has it hurt them? What does this last session mean for the people of New York State?
Well, we've had two good years, and I say that with confidence. When we took over 2 years ago, the state Senate, at that point you had two governors in a couple of years. You had a state house that was run by a Democratic House. And unfortunately, what we've seen was the increase in taxes and fees by taxes alone, $14 billion in the worst economic time since the Great Depression in 2009, 2008, 2010. And we were able to come to office and over the last 2 years with a balance with a Republican Senate, Democratic Assembly, and a Democratic governor, and we were able to come to terms on a number of issues. And we managed to pass a budget that was $10 billion in monies that we had to find, and we did it by savings. We went in there and we meticulously went through the budget, and we found the savings that we needed to be able to balance this $132 billion budget. Still a specific, it's still a pretty large budget, but we were able to balance it within that number, and to keep and not pass on any new taxes and fees. And by doing that, we were able to not only cut, but we also cut spending. We put a property tax cap into effect. We did a Medicaid spending. We have a Medicaid redesign team that is actually concentrating not on just the city of New York, but the state, and has some significant savings to it. We're working in Brooklyn to make sure that Coney Island Hospital and Maimonides and Lutheran and Presbyterian, all these different hospitals that we need to make sure that the that we get good health care system, and to be able to make sure we do the right cuts, not the bad cuts, and that we don't have anybody falling between the cracks. We were able to consolidate agencies, and we were able to end some of the bureaucracies and see some savings. We were able to work with the MTA and trying to restore some of the cuts that we've seen come into our communities over the past several years, and to make sure that there is a cohesiveness within the agency. We did the lockbox last year, which let the money in the system that if there's any money to come out through savings, that we didn't grab that money like we have in the past, and that we leave the money in the system and allow the system to grow. I think that was important. And we were able to not only save the people in our city, but across the state, 4.4 million people actually witnessed a tax reduction. And $3.3 billion in tax cuts. These are important things that I think the people of our city and state recognize today. Made sure we maintained our public safety, make sure we took care of our education, and putting in $290 million this year into the Department of Education to make sure we get the smaller class size, to make sure that we address the concerns in my community and the communities across Brooklyn and across the city. So I think we did an outstanding job. And, you know, we talked about the MTA, that's that MTA payroll tax that really strikes to the heart of many of our companies and many of the businesses. And we were able to go in there and cut back on the MTA tax. And that really helped us too. 200,000 small businesses, 400,000 people that are self-employed, they seen an immediate tax break. And I think that's the type of things you want to be able to do, is to strive balance, be able to deliver on services, but yet to do it in a responsible way. Get rid of the bloat, find ways to save dollars, and put those dollars back into the system.
Senator Golden, is it fair to say that over the last couple of years, the philosophy of budgeting in New York State has changed? In previous years, when you the legislature had been plagued by late budgets, and two, very often, as you well know, you were dealing with $10, $15 billion in a deficit, because it was built in, there was built-in spending year after year. Has that appears to have stopped in the last couple of years. Is that a fair statement?
We definitely stopped in this past year, the $10 billion in deficit. We made that money up, like I said, and going in and looking at this budget and cutting where we had to cut, and did it successfully, and still managed to put a tax cap in across the state of New York, a 2% tax cap. Still managed to do it without adding any new taxes or fees to the people here in our great city and state. So that's the way it works by coming. And we still got, you know, not we got next year, and we're looking at reducing spending again. We just finished this budget this year, and that budget is in good shape. But going into next year, we have a $2 billion deficit, which we have to deal with, and we will. And in these tough economic times, that's pretty good. I mean, that's what you want to be able to do. Get rid of the stealth tax. We got rid of the taxes on the 18, on the energies. We got rid of a whole host of taxes that were, you know, these hidden taxes, these taxes that were scoring at the ratepayers and the taxpayers in the city and state, and still managed to come up with I think a pretty good outcome. We've created job-creating tax cuts that work, and I think the film tax credit is one where we actually put a lot of people to work. We got working with the biotech industrial park and getting tax breaks to the Brooklyn Army Terminal and to the East River Project so that we can get businesses in there to start to develop. And we see what's going on with the finishing up in Brooklyn with the Nets Stadium very, very shortly. And then, of course, the housing units will be built. We'll see more building going on in the city. We've just seen this past couple of weeks that the governor and the president, the governor of both states, Christie and Governor Cuomo, and the president of the United States and the mayor of the city of New York signed the top piece of steel to go on the World Trade Center. That's the type of work we want to see. We see the Hudson Yards getting ready to embark on a major, major construction project. We see Moynihan Station. We see the Jacob Javits Center. We see the Second Avenue line proceeding. What we want to be able to do is to create these public-private partnerships, which we've talked about here in the state of New York, and working with, say, the Tappan Zee Bridge. And a lot of people don't know that the World Trade Center, that's a public-private partnership. We have in there one company put in $100 million, and they are partners in one of the buildings at the World Trade Center. Another company put in $90 million, and they're going to be a partner on the ground floor when it comes to some of the marketing of some of the commercial area. That's what you want to be able to do, is set up these private-public partnerships. Public-private partnerships on the East Side Access. You know, people building the escalators coming up from the train, from the platforms, and that's money that was brought in from the federal government and from private entities as well. So what you want to be able to do is set up the opportunity to create more jobs. The more jobs we create, the more taxes we get from those jobs. That creates the economic engine that makes our city, our state, and our counties and villages and towns across this great state work. So I'm very proud of it, and it continues to do a good job.
Senator Golden, I know that as a former New York City police officer, you were very interested in seeing the DNA data bank expanded. And I believe you were also interested in combating child pornography. Can you kind of bring us up to speed on if the Assembly has been working with us and whether New Yorkers are going to see a benefit and be better protected as a result of this session?
Well, not only did we deal, obviously, in a responsible accounting process that allowed us to balance our budgets and to reduce deficit spending here in the state of New York, and to go after some of our authorities and to bring our authorities into balance as well. We also went after the different areas that would keep our communities safe, and the DNA database is one of those areas where you actually go in and you take a swath of someone's mouth and you can run that, and you can find out if that individual, it's like an FBI, it's like a fingerprint, and it's as good as a fingerprint, and you can identify the DNA and who that individual is. Well, the DNA database enhancement adds about 40,000 swabs per year. So we'll be able to find out that individual that went in there and hurt and raped and murdered and pillaged, will be able to turn around and find out and access those individuals and put them behind bars where they belong. And I think you'll see us working closely and making sure that that's well funded and that that gets off the ground well. There's a whole host of areas that we worked in. I-STOP is another area that we just did with the prescription pills, the OxyContin and hydrocodone. These are pills that unfortunately didn't go to our parents and into our homes and into our medicine cabinets, and they start taking these pills out, and they were going to parties, these kids, and they dumped the prescription pills into a bowl, and the kids would come in and take it. They'd call them a Skittle party or a trail mix party, and we've seen just in my area and the Dyker Heights and Bay Ridge and Bensonhurst area and February through May, I've seen five kids between the ages of 17 and 21 killed from overdoses. Now, I'm just one senator in a large, tremendous state, and our communities are not by any means the worst. Staten Island is by far one of the worst in the state, and Nassau and Suffolk County. So by creating this new, where you're going to be able to respond, and the pharmacies and the doctors will be in sync with e-scripts, so that we'll know exactly how many scripts are out there. We'll be able to find out if the guy goes to one doctor and then goes to another doctor and goes to another doctor, and it's called doctor shopping. We'll be able to stop that because it'll be in time when these prescriptions are written. We'll be able to know why you got a prescription, why you got OxyContin, and we'll be able to track that OxyContin. If you go to a dentist, and you don't really need to be able to have 30 pills. You only need pills for 5 days. We'll be able to start to curtail those pills, and a whole host of bills we went in and corrected. We'll save lives with that bill. We'll stop the OxyContin and the codeine from going into the streets. We did a child porn bill. Child porn was legal here in the state of New York because of a court ruling a month ago. We went in, we worked with the assembly, and hopefully very shortly working with the governor, that will be no longer happen here in our community. Those are the types of bills. We got a cyberbullying bill that I think that's important for our kids in, across this state. That's being negotiated right now, that I think that will be done as well. So we took a whole host of not just the accounting side of our ledger. We also went in and helped the legal standing of some of these bills, so we can make our communities safer and have that good quality of life where people want to be able to stay and live in this great city and raise a family. And that's what it's all about, giving people the quality of life that they deserve.
Senator Golden, after, as I mentioned at the beginning of this program, we are in the throes of the end of session. And I hope to have you back after session is complete. And you can really give us a firm rundown on if the Assembly followed through on protecting our families and how we're doing on our job creation. I want to thank you very much for your time, Senator Golden.
Thank you very much, John.
And we'll see you soon.